Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy, and today I am going to solve rational equations. Rational equations just means that you have fractions in your equations with variables in the denominator. And so we always want to remember to look for restrictions, and restrictions are values that cause the denominator to equal zero. We don't want any denominator to ever be zero. Find the least common denominator, multiply every term by the least common denominator, and this will eliminate the fractions in your problem. You may get a fractional answer, but you won't have to deal with fractions throughout the problem. Solve the resulting equation, and then check your answer to make sure you don't have any of those restrictions that you found up there in the first place. Let's take a look at the first two problems. These have restrictions because they have a denominator with a variable in them. And so what would the restriction be for this problem? Well, we don't want the denominator to equal zero. So pretty straightforward on this one, x cannot be zero. What do you think the restriction is for number two? Well, we don't want the denominator to be zero. If x was negative two, negative two plus two would be zero. So our restriction over here is x cannot be negative two. So I'm going to work these problems, and when I get the answer, I want to make sure that I don't get one of those. I don't get zero here, and I don't get negative two there. So the first thing I'm going to do is find the least common denominator, and I have an x and a two. And remember, I have a one under here as well, but that doesn't really change my LCD. When I have two distinct numbers, I don't know what x is, so I have to assume it's not a two, or I don't know, but what I'm saying is, if we don't know that number, we're just going to multiply those two values together. So 2 times x is 2x, so my LCD is 2x, and I'm going to multiply everything times 2x. And I'm putting a 1 under the 2x, you wouldn't have to do that, but just so we know that it's in the numerator. And so what happens is these x's cancel, 1 times 2 is 2. Nothing cancels here, 2x times 3 is 6x. And then the 2's cancel over here, and I get x. Notice I don't have any fractions left now. I just can work this problem without the fractions. I'm going to subtract 6x from both sides and divide both sides by the coefficient, which is negative 5. Coefficient is the number multiplying the variable. And that gives me x is negative 2/5, and that is not a restriction. A restriction was zero for this problem, so my answer is negative 2/5, and I could plug that back in to check it. Now, I'll leave that for you. And now I'm going to come over here. I know that x can't be negative 2 because that's my restriction. But what's the LCD? Again, I have a 1 here. This term is going to get multiplied by the LCD, even though it doesn't contribute to it. But the only denominator I have is x plus 2. So x plus 2 is my LCD, and I can put parentheses around it because it's a binomial if I want to. I'm still thinking of that as being on the numerator, so I want to put a 1 under it. Notice that nothing cancels here, and 1 times x plus 2 is just x plus 2. Here the x plus 2's go, leaving the 3x, and here I'm going to have negative 6 times x plus 2's cancel, sorry, negative 6 times nothing. All I have left is a negative 6. So cancel, and then you see what's left. Now I have 3x and x, which is 4x, and I have a negative 2 I'm going to take away from both sides, leaving 0 there and negative 8 here. To get rid of the coefficient, I'm going to divide by it, and that leaves me x equals negative 2. That's a problem because we said x could not be negative 2. Negative 2 plus 2 is 0. That would make that undefined. So I can't use that. And I would just say no solution. There's no solution to that problem because the solution I got was a restriction for the problem. Okay, sometimes you have to factor in order to find your LCD. And the factoring is something that you've done in a previous chapter, so I'm not spending time explaining factoring, but I just want you to see when you have a problem like number 3, before you could find the restrictions or before you can find the LCD, you have to be sure of what your actual denominators are. So I'm going to rewrite this. With this part in factored form, x squared minus 25 is x, is it? It's a difference of squares, so you get x plus 5 and x minus 5. So if you have any of your denominators, excuse me, that need to be factored, you should do that and then decide what your restrictions are, what your LCD is. When I look at this, I can see this one was supposed to be minus. That would have caused problems. Be careful, but more careful than me. So this one, if x was negative 5, negative 5 plus 5 would be 0. So I can't let x be negative 5. And this one, if x was 5, it would be 0. So I can't have negative 5 or 5. And you can see that these two are the same thing. I can't have negative 5 or 5. So that doesn't add anything new to it. And what's the least common denominator here? Well, I need an x plus 5 and an x minus 5. And I have the same things over here. It doesn't add anything new to it. So I'm multiplying times the LCD every term. And what's going to happen here is those x plus 5s are going to cancel, leaving me 2 times x minus 5. Then the x minus 5s cancel here, leaving me 1 times x plus 5, which is just x plus 5. And over here, the x plus 5 and the x minus 5 both cancel, which leaves 16. So now I can solve the problem, the resulting equation, that's the number step 4. I can solve this by distributing and then simplifying 2x and x is 3x. Negative 10 plus 5 is negative 5. That I simplified that. Now I'm going to add 5 to both sides and then divide by the coefficient. And I get x equals 7. Well, is 7 one of my restrictions? No. I had negative 5 and 5. So 7 is my answer. It was not a restriction on this problem. All right, let's look at the last one. What are the restrictions here? Well, the restrictions are a little trickier because you have this more complicated looking denominator. But I know for sure that y cannot be 0 because 0, the y is standalone. What can't it be here? Well, if you can't see it, you can write it off to the side and solve it. You don't want it to be 0. So if you do 4y equals negative 1 by bringing the 1 to the other side and dividing by 4, you can see that y should not equal negative 1/4. So that's our other restriction, 0 and negative 1/4. What's our LCD? Well, I have 4y plus 1 and I have a standalone y. That y is not part of that. Those are just two different numbers. So my LCD is y and 4y plus 1. So I'm going to cancel the y's, and I have a negative out front, so I'm going to go ahead and write that negative, and then 4y plus 1. And then I have the 4y plus 1's that cancel, and I have negative 2y. And then I have 4y plus 1's that cancel, and I have negative 8y times y, or y squared. So now this problem is different. They all have a little different scenario. This one, we just had one solution that was fine. This one, we had one solution that was not okay because it was a restriction. This one, we had to factor. And now this one, we have a second power term. So that makes that problem different and harder. Let me distribute this. Negative 4y minus 1 equals negative 2y minus 8y squared. When I have a second degree equation like this, I want to move everything to one side, set everything equal to 0, and then I can factor, or I can use the quadratic equation or whatever I need, the quadratic formula, excuse me, to solve that. So let me move this by adding 8y to both sides, 8y squared. I'm going to put the 8y squared over here. And then add 2y to both sides. Negative 4y and positive 2y is negative 2y. And then I have that minus 1. And now I have 0 over there. So this is what I want to factor. And you can factor that using the box method, or you can factor using whatever method that you like to use. The box method, I would put my terms like this. First term over the first column. last term over the second column, middle term down below. Notice I put the signs with it. I know for one, the only thing I can do is have 1 times 1. These two boxes have to multiply to be what's on top. One of these needs to be negative. I'm going to wait on that for a second. I have some options with 8, 1 and 8, or 2 and 4 as factors. And I know I want to get to 2, so it makes sense to use 2 and 4. So I'm going to do 2y and 4y. And then I multiply across, I get 2y and 4y. Which one of those should be negative for me to add those up and get negative 2y? Well, that should be negative. Now, I'm not intending on teaching the box method here. So if this doesn't make sense to you, you can go back and watch the videos where I do explain the box method, and then you could come back. So anyway, I need this to be negative, so this is the one. So 2y times 1 is 2y. 4y times negative 1 is negative 4y, and those add up to negative 2y. And I know that these two things multiply to 8y squared, and these two things multiply to negative 1. So my answer is on the diagonal. So what I get is 4y plus 1 and 2y minus 1. That's my factored form, and you might have done that differently. Maybe you don't need something like the box method. And now I'm going to solve both of those. 4y plus 1 equals 0, and 2y minus 1 equals 0. 4y is negative 1, or y is negative 1 fourth. 2y equals 1, or y is 1 half. So, let's think about the restrictions. Remember up here, check your answers for restrictions. Y is negative 1 fourth, can't use it because it's a restriction. Y is 1 half, that's fine. So my answer is y equals 1 half. Even though I had two solutions, I only could use one of those because it was a restriction. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you.